Good morning, guys. Thank you so much for coming on the Saturday morning. Really appreciate your timings. Today we are going to discuss about Postman, which all of you guys use in your day-to-day operations for the APIs and few other things as well. Mr. Wasim Mansoori from our Android team department is going to explore the more advanced versions of a Postman, how it can help you to do the more tasks with the less efforts. Let's explore that what he is trying to share. Yes, Wasim, thank you for coming and thank you for scheduling this. Over to you.
Thank you very much, sir. First off, thank you very much for giving me this opportunity. Hello, good morning, everyone. I hope everyone is fine and safe at home. So today's topic is Postman, means how can we use it advanced level. So we know that we are using Postman, we have been using Postman since few years. So what is the my purpose of to give this presentation? We can use some effectively Postman, like how can we minimize our effort to prevent API manually putting our all those things API, how can we prevent all those things? So how can we implement our automation testing by using Postman? So these kind of things we can check in details. So first, what is the agenda of the today presentation? I would like explain the few basic things about the Postman, how we can set up the variables in Postman and at different scope level. And how can we implement the testing API? How can we implement our automation testing for this? And how we can do the change requests for the particular requirement and for the some circumstance? And also we can implement the some runner feature or one of the good feature of the Postman. As we know that Postman is a phenomenal tools for it helps us to. We can easily visualize the actually how we can put our APIs, all those things. So basic of Postman, like I will show by some these tools. You can see this is a tool of Postman where we can access our API. We can manage and organize all our API in well structured manner. So these are we can start from basic like this. So you can create the some whatever you want to create the request. If you want to create the collection environment, we can create from this panel. So this is a starting point of the in Postman. If this is the panel of the request builder where we can put our API request parameter, URL, endpoint. And based on our API, we can choose the whatever method is we have to integrate for the particular API. We can do this is the body parameter of the particular API. Whatever what we want to pass, like we want to pass the form data, raw data, all those things we can pass from here. So this is a very few basic things we are using so many years. So what we can do, what we can see, like if I'm executing for particular API, right? I have taken the example of for SGM. Like you can see that this is the response panel of the Postman. In that you can see the some data analytical report for the API. You can see that these data. you can see the what is the certificate is used, what will be protocol for, so we can get the all information which are related of the server by calling this API. And we can also observe the time, how much time has been taken by the particular API. In week, you can also check the by forget what is the actually time has been taken for the socket initialization, TCP handshakes, and so based on these analytical reports, we can identify where our API is taking the time and where we can improve our things. So these are analytical report for the particular API. So we can put our, we can easily get the idea actually what is the statistics for it. So we can improve whatever if we require for it. We can see the size of it, what is the actually size. Has arrived in the particular response. We can check that response body and header as well. This is a save response. Like if you want to, if like sometime what happens, like the response very large. If you want to structure in well, also in some right manner, we can all directly save that response in file. So it will be our hard disk. So and few things you can observe. This is console. In console, like whatever you are creating requests, whatever your API is calling, that will be each and everything is we can see in console. So they are keep means whatever our postman is keep tracking to us what we are actually doing the for the API calling. So we can analyze the all the information from console as well. So this is a very basic things of the postman. Okay, now variables. As we are know, variable is why we are using variable. Like what happens in some APIs, like few things is used for the multiple places, like in multiple requests. So we cannot put the for in each. We cannot put the each our values in per each and every API. Instead of we can put in some global way, some central level. So we can directly take from that central level. By that, we can utilize our time and we can easily change if we want to change in further. And we can optimize our testing level by putting some values at some central level. We can use that environment means variable feature of the Postman. So basically in Postman, first thing is workspace. In workspace, you can create the multiple collection. In collection, you can create the multiple request. Okay. And this is the environment panel. So variable can be created at three place majorly. Like if you want to create environment level, you can create environment level. If you want to create the, this is the panel like, where we can see, okay, these are two panels. These are, if you want to define the variable some environment level, we can define it environment level. If you want to define some global level, we can define at global level as well. If you want to define some collection level, we can also define the some collection level. So that is depend on our requirement where actually we want to use these are variables. Like we have to measure our requirement for that. So accordingly we can put the variables. Like if you put in environment variable, you can use the for multiple collection. If you put at global level, you can use the multiple environment. So you can get the better idea by some diagram, like what is where actually scope of existing for the particular variable, that is a from global to collection to environment and data and local. So these are hierarchical of the variable scope. So based on our requirement, so we can use these variables, I means we can define based on this scope. And one more thing I would like to concentrate all the body, like what is the main difference between initial value and current value? So initial value is a default value and current value is like what for the in from if we are working as a collaborative as a team. So if we have to give the like we have to give someone to access only the development part, no need to give us some live data for the testing. So current value actually if you will put in some whatever your testing data, whatever you value, but it will be stored in only your local session until you will not persist that value. So whenever you sync to cloud, so a teammate couldn't check this value. Like if you want to check any confidential data, like any credit card related, all those things. So we can put in current value. We should not put in the initial value, because if we will sync the, so initial value will goes to, it will be shared across the devices and multiple our teammates. So there may cause to some accidentally data threading, all those things happen. So we can, we have to care about while we are using these values for the variable. So we have to always change the current value for our individual usage. And we should not always checkbox for persist all. Otherwise, it will be saved in cloud as well, and other teammate also can check this current value. So current value has a session only though for the individual particular one user, until you will not check the persist value of it. So these are things for the environment variable. Okay, now our is limitation and restriction, like some API developer is creating the API, and our means more developers are checking the all those things API. So what happens sometimes, what we are doing, we are just putting this header parameter, body parameter and token, all those things. We are keep putting this value as a manually, but Postman is provide to how we can automate all those things. Like whatever the, we are sure that in some API client, we are sure that we have to pass only this parameter and this value. So before the executing actual API, we can set some constraint. We can put some script for it. So that will be automatically executed. We don't have to put the manually one by one. So you can see the one of the option, the pre-request script here. Like if I assume that I want to pass in second API customer ID, right? So this is a basic free script code which is supported by Node.js, and we can write our script like from the first API, okay, from the login API. Okay, pre-request script, what is actually, it is associated to the each API request. It will be executed before the our actual API is executed. So each pre-request script is we are just what we want to pass the data for the particular request. We can pass the some dynamically. No need to put the everything in manually. We can just put some script code. So in Postman tutorial also some ready-made script available, like we can see the here some example of snippet. You can see the example of this snippet. Like I want to get the we have a defined some variable here, like base URL, customer ID. So we can find the values from the environment variable by using the particular key. So this prerequisite script, like just assume that if I want to access the few orders, the particular user. So how can we do first? I want to, I need the user ID of that user. So by getting that user ID, we can pass the user ID in the next API. So how can we can get that API from this particular key, and we can pass this key as a request parameter in form of prerequisite script. This is a test form. This test form is associated with the response of the each API. So you will get the better idea by. So this is a life cycle of the prerequisite test and the test. Like you can see the prerequisite script is associated with the request and the test script associated to response. So we have to decide like some circumstances arrive at like what we want to pass for the request. We can put those value by using the variable, and we want to check the some test like our API is working successfully. If someone has changed something, we have to check the something should not be broken by the someone. So we can check our test suits. So we can check our test suit as well. So for this, I would like to give some example for it. Like you can see the my login API where you can see these are parameters. In next API, I want to pass the my two parameters, like one customer ID and one is the access token for the user. So you can see the access token. I'm not writing anything manually. All those things working as the automation, like you can see the, let me execute a login API. This is my response of the login API, right? So I want to pass this value to the next API. How can we pass like till now we are passing, we are putting some taking this value from this and we are putting some manually. Instead of we can directly means you can see the already I set this access token and from the login tests I have already updated value. You can see this variable I have taken from this. I fetched the access token and I just updated to the my glow collection variable this value. So we can change the dynamical value for the particular API. So this is my access token has been changed by this line. And now when I will execute this API, I don't have to write anything manually. It will directly will take from the our collection variable. Okay, you can observe one thing here also, like whatever we can write our test suit as well. Like if you want to identify like some requirement what will come like some parameter, some value should be come in response. So we can put our test suits here. So what test suits here, we can write some JavaScript code for the demo purpose. I just use this line status code or 200. Like if I want to fail this status code, I can fail by this way. Here you can see the some snippets like different purpose. We can use the whatever the fetch, like how can we actually read the JSON, hold the body, and how can we retrieve some parameter from it. So now you can see the I have just failed. I mean forcefully I executed the fail case. So we can implement our automation testing by this way. So you can also observe the console for the each API. Like you can print the particular value for it. Like I have, you can see the my test suits for the login API, what I have written code. Also, second thing, I also means I have set the customer ID by taking from in same response. You can observe the one more thing, like, so we are sure that some requirements, some parameter, some value we have to pass as across the multiple API. So we have to set those variable some according that scope, and we can change the we can change those value by this scripting. So what we can save our times, and we don't have to write each and everything manually. So it will be help and quickly way to execute our APIs, and we can identify if anything wrong occur or not easily. This is test series that you can observe from here.
Okay, Vasim, this is a really good feature. Let's team explore the things by their own, how they wanted to write the scripts and how they wanted to intervene. This is a good information to share just for the exploration purpose. Let's move on for the next.
Okay. Okay. One more means advanced feature of the Postman is collection runner. Runner is a, you can see the, like in some situation, like we want to call the API in some consecutive manners, like we have to call some sequential manner. So we can use the runner feature of the API, where we can put the sequence of our APIs. Like you can, as per the my for example demonstration, I have taken the login and get means as I want to get the salesperson list which are assigned to particular me. So this is a sequence for me, right? So how can we execute this sequence in some automation manner? I don't want to check the one by one, like I don't want to take the login response and put in these things. I just need some tools there where I can just put click on some one button, it will be work as automatically. So you can see that this is a runner feature of it. We can take the demonstration of Sam. Okay, you can see that this is a form of the collection runner, like what collection you want to put as a runner. So you can choose from that, which environment do you want to set, and what, how much iteration do you means you require, means this collection can be run whatever you are giving the iteration count. So that based on that will be executed. You can put also delay, means how much delay you require to between the two iterations. So we can put the time based on, and this is data file is, this is the key value pair. Like what happens, we if you want to check the data for the some sequential manner, means I want to check the customer list for the 10 users. So I can put the some JSON file here with the key value pair, all 10 users ID I can put in data file. So based on 10 iteration, it will take the from the one by one. So these are automation things inbuilt running by the Postman. So here is, let me take one example of for SGM. You can see the sequence run order. Like you can, if you maybe here you can see the list of APIs. So you can choose whatever you want to put in some runner. If you don't require to put any particular request, you can uncheck. And here I want to set the some environment. So I have set. So these are my sequence I want to execute as a automation. So let me click on run for SGM. Okay, you can see now complete analytical of the report. You can see the means I have written the two test cases. Those are passed. Now you can check the one by one execution of the my API. If you want to check the further, you can go in console for the API. So you can see the more detailed reports. In these also in console, you can see the what things arrived from the server side, all the parameter you can observe. Then you can also observe the sequence. So whatever I set the sequence in that manner is executed by automation. So we can get idea like we are in future some things like I want to execute in some sequential manner. So we can put this some, we can use the collection runner feature of it. You can observe the, all those things. So many things arrived which will help for us to analyze the API. You can see the test cases, all those things. So whatever means I have written the for temporary purpose. So this is a collection runner feature which will working as a automation API testing. And we can easily get the idea if anything break, if anything happens.
Hi Vaseem.
Hello.
Asya here.
Yes.
So I think this collection runner we can also use for performance and load balancing test for APIs as well. So let's say there are 10 users and they are hitting API 100 times. So what output comes? What are the number of APIs going into success and failure? This output we can receive. Right.
Yes, we can receive, and also for the performance level, we can use the monitor feature of Postman.
Correct. So let's say some API is getting a response in 5 seconds, and 100 APIs are now going to call. Then what would be the average second to respond for the particular API that we can receive here?
Yes.
It would be beneficial to know like what happens. We check the performance and load balancing for website. Mobile application. From this tool, we can also check for the API because the two systems are okay at their level, the website and the mobile application. But the integration, which is a bridge between mobile and website as an API, so that also we can figure out from here.
Yes.
Correct. This is beneficial.
Okay. This is the you can see the analytical report of the collection.
I think there should be a microseconds or something like API response. Usually the number of bytes are there and milliseconds are there.
Yes.
It's beneficial.
Also,
one API is failed, two APIs are passed. So there is a benefit.
Yes, you can means you can complete analyze the what how much time has been taken for the particular API and complete our requirements. Like we are in some situation we are dependent for the some API, like as I said that we have to call the some sequential manner API, so we can check those API in this tool, so we can easily get the idea of how much time has been taken for it.
Correct.
Okay, for the like in our routine things, hello, in our routine things, like we are observed so many things, like some what means I found some complaint for like few developers are saying that hello.
Yes, Vaseem.
Some noises.
Yeah, go ahead, don't worry.
A few complaints I means found, like a few developers I said like unexpectedly some collection is arrived from the our account, and some collection might be some accidentally deleted. So in our free version of Postman, all those features are not available. But if we will go the paid version of like enterprise version of Postman, so there are some all the privilege access available for the user, like you can, there are some role available admin level, developer level, viewer level. So like we have to face this situation until we are not going to the paid version, enterprise version of the Postman. So Postman is not tracking for the trial version. If anything accidentally related, you can get, but some limitation and some restriction are there. Like if might be some situation that accidentally deleted some collection, so that collection is automatically goes to the some trace of the Postman. So where we can get idea how far that that collection is reside in the trace level. So like you can observe free account can be recovered by 1 day old. And team account can be recovered in 30 days. It means whatever accidentally deleted our collection will reside in trace until the 1 day for the free account, 30 days for the team account. Now, if we will go the enterprise account, it will be reside for the 19 days. And like we have to whatever you can see the year from the team main. Like from here we can create the workspace, and workspace for the workspace we can assign the some role, we can means what people we need to call for the this workspace we can do by this way. Only one thing we cannot get in free version, like we cannot make this workspace as a private. If you want to make this workspace, we have to purchase the enterprise version of it. So we can do by that way. So this is a like this is a form where we can create individually or team level, or we can give the access of the team, like what kind of access give, like the I don't want to give the access the person who cannot create any variable or cannot edit the variable, so I can give those access as well, but only this feature is available in enterprise version. So enterprise version, so lots of features also means lots of user level privilege access available in enterprise version, so we can manage that team level as best as a collaboratively. One thing I would like to tell, but I haven't implemented, but I would like to give the some basic few things for it, like the monitor collection. As a monitor collection, like we have to schedule some timing for it, like how we can it will give the some complete the analytical report for the our APIs, means where actually delay, where actually fail. So post means keep tracking our collection by enabling the monitor collection. One more feature is mock collection. Mock collections, like by implementing mock collection, we can testing our API some based on some mock data. So we can use these features as well. One more feature is a public docs. Like we have to make our API collection like as a global. It means more people can use, so we can directly use this feature of public docs from the postman. So this will be helpful us to manage easily for the while we are publishing our API some to the our end user level. So a developer can be use these APIs for the their purpose. So here you can see the history of the APIs where I call it from the one by one. And also one thing you observe here is syncing. You have to sync the whatever, if you are working as a team, you are working as a collaborator, you must have to sync whatever you are changing. Those changes are going to cloud, and you can access all those changes from the another device. Means you can use the across the multiple device. So you have to sync all those changes to get the data up to date from the any device. So we have to sync all those things. For proxy and interceptor, I haven't used any demo, but I would like to turn some few just overview of it, the proxy and interceptor. Like proxy, by proxy we can track our like just attach your devices any simulator, so we can track the what API is calling from our device. So like free configuration, we can check the how much API is calling from in which sequence by in history, so we can set the proxy for it. And this is the overall basic advanced tools of the Postman, where we just I hope that everyone can use and optimize their efforts, and they can get the better more benefit from this. So from as of now, from my side, done. I hope everyone will get some benefit from it. So mercy, sir, from my side, done now.
Okay, thank you so much for the insights. Team, we have any questions for this?
Yes, I have. I was in Rohit here.
Yes, yes.
Vaseem, I don't know one thing in Postman. I really want to know that if I want to check upload feature through Postman, how can I able to check that?
Upload feature means what? Upload, yeah. What do you want?
Suppose
to
I want to check upload file feature through
profile image.
Postman.
Profile yeah. image, maybe.
Yes.
We
yes.
can do that from the multi-part. That you all can do like, here. Features are supported here. You can browse the image in your computer and you can upload.
Okay, can you please show me one practical so I can be able to...
Yes, you can see here. Like image, you have to decide the type of it.
Okay.
File, right?
Okay.
Now you can choose the file.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
If image is going into base64, then it would be the string. If image is going into the multi-part, then it would be the file.
So there are two types of uploading file, right? One of the base64 and is one of the form data. Form data, it means that the file is going in streaming form. So you can use the form data.
Okay. So if suppose I am uploading a PDF or something, a Word file, then it will be it will go through a base64.
No, what is actually compatibility for the from API side? You have to first check.
Both way you can do.
Okay, I can do both way. Okay, Vaseem,
by base64 as well. And Rohit, one second. You can do by both ways, base64 and multi-part upload as well. But base64 has a limitation. You cannot upload image or any document or any file more than 5 MB.
Okay.
So then it will go in an infinite loop. So if we have a limited acceptance from the mobile application, like image should be within a 2 MB or 3 MB, then base64 is better. If it is beyond 2 MB, 3 MB, 5 MB, then the multi-part is better. But nowadays we do in the multi-part only.
Okay. Files. So multi-part is a good
10 MB, 15 MB, or then we upload on individual.
Okay. So according to you, multi-part is a good choice. Only. Okay. So according to you, multi-part part is a good choice, right? Hello.
Yes, Rohit.
Okay. Vaseem, you have selected .mp4 here in the image.
Yes, we can select any media file, no problem.
Okay.
Okay, any question from team?
So, success.
Yes, Rohit.
So we get the success on this? Okay,
no, this is only I haven't implemented some API, means media uploading API. We have to implement, we have to set the parameter, all those things for a particular API.
Okay, understand. Body form data. Okay, got you. Thank you.
Okay, let me explain a few things about here. You can observe. This is we have raw data, means what is the raw data? Like we want to pass the JSON data that we can pass the in raw data. Form data, what we want to pass the some key value pair, like some in part key value part, like we don't want to say send data in some JSON format. So we can pass this data in form data. And I want to some encoding implementation for the passing data, so I can use the form URL encoding data. Like here we can use the some only if you want to pass only file, right? So you can choose the file only here. If you don't want to pass anything, you can choose here this type of none where you don't want to pass anything.
So by selecting a binary, you can upload an image also.
Yes.
Okay.
Here
no MB limitations from here. If you upload from binary section, then
yes, binary, like in binary there is no any limitation. Ultimately in streaming also we are sending the binary.
Mm-hmm.
Right, so we are just removing one layer, by using this binary.
So what is the difference between binary and form data by uploading a file through form data and by uploading a file through binary? What is the difference between them?
In form data, we are passing key value pair. In binary, okay. we are not passing the key value. We are just sure I want only files. So you cannot pass the other data in binary.
Okay.
So form data, you can pass the data as well file content.
Okay, got it.
And because of that, binary only accept a one file only. It cannot accept any other user ID or category ID. Or a product ID. So we never because none of our API and requirement is to upload any one particular image only.
Okay.
And further means Postman is also supported like so many languages from where we can get the call. Actually, if I want to access the for the Java, I can review this code for the how can actually API is executing from the Postman, so I can got all those code from as well this. So many APIs and I mean so many language supported, so we can observe the actually code of it. And one more thing,
it's
here
like a piece of code snippet only, but the structure like retrogate or like MVVM or MVC, whatever we structure we develop, that doesn't go exactly suitable into it. This is just like snippet only.
This is also bulk edit. Like if you want to directly copy the key value pair, means you can copy directly whatever content and you can put in some next API. So this is a bulk key value edit. So we can use also. This is very main things like how much time has been taken. We can observe this and what is actually size of it. All this bifurcation available. Total how much means TCP handshake time has been taken. All those things.
Okay.
Okay, sounds good.
Wasim,
yes.
Sorry. Yes. Wasim, before that there is a cookie. What is the working of that cookie over there?
Cookie is like in website level for identifying the data. Like means like you are logging website in Facebook, right? So all the session is managed by some cookies value. Means one of the anonymous.
So no. I want to ask you. We can check the cookies also from here. I know what is cookie, but I want to know that we can check the cookies value from here.
Yes, we can check, but I haven't checked it for the cookies as of now from the Postman because cookies also, I think we can see. Yes, I think one more feature is in coming soon in the Postman, like actually how to completely manage the cookies at mobile level. Like what happens in e-commerce application if you execute the e-commerce API means merchant to API iPhone, they are cookies are managing inbuilt in iOS. If you will go the Android, some we have to explicit write the code for the managing cookies. And even we are not able to check in Postman. So I think you can see that this screen is beta version of the Postman. I think in future they are releasing the cookies version. So how we can check the API level as well.
Okay. Good. Thank you.
Okay. Team anyone facing any issues like while working with APIs, while working with the backend developers, and if you are facing any issues that you wanted to share, how to resolve that via Postman, or even if it not can be resolved by Postman, then still you can ask such question. Hitesh, are you facing any issues with the APIs?
Yes, sir.
So what issues you are facing?
In delete method, how can we pass request body? In Postman, it is working, but Android side, it is not working.
So that is part of the Android side R&D only, how we can do. So we had a delete API for the profile image in Grow app. So they were able to implement on a web level, on an API level. But we were not somehow able to manage from the Android and iOS. So then we have converted one more method for the post, and from the post parameter they were passing to the delete method. So that we need to take a time on it, and we can try. Let's say next week we are free, then we can do it on iOS and Android side, like how we can implement it. And we have to collaborate with the API developers as well, like what would be the ideal way.
And for the for any particular API, right, we are, like as you said, it is in Android, iOS working, in Android is not working. But all the for API structure, all the some standard protocol has been followed, right? So like we have to follow the all the means protocol and rules for the calling the API. So if anything is missing, so we couldn't get the success. So we, I know there's some limitation in Android, like as I said, the for cookies we have to pass the some explicit level. So we have to check the both the compatibility from the front side and back end sides. Both can be both should be communicate the same parameter which are required for the executing the API.
So it is there are API types: get, post, put, delete. So delete we encountered first time. So we need to look into that way, like how we can do delete type of API in the future. Delete is just going to delete an object from the particular DB. And there is inbuilt API we encountered first time within an e-commerce platform, WooCommerce platform on a WordPress. So we will look into it and we will figure out the way. So yeah, also, we need to check from the front end.
Asha, sir.
Yes.
In GrowApp also we pass the cookies in cart listing API, you know. Then Postman, yes. How can we check or pass cookies?
Actually, what happens when you see here, see there are cookies 2, header 18, test result 0 of 1, right? So there are 2 cookies automatically there available. Vasim, can you mouse over it? Yes. So what happens when you do JW type of API, like token-based API, when you log in, you receive a 1 token, and that token you pass into another API's header. That moment, your session automatically getting freeze, and your cookies are within that session. So you see here, Vasim has not tried to save any kind of cookies. He has not done anything specially for the cookies on a Postman as well. But this has taken automatically. So in Postman, for the cookies, you don't need to do anything. It is automatically going to manage. Because you are managing your session. So Vasim has shown a collection runner, right? So there are various number of APIs, and he has also shown like one API is giving a response that key, how we can take it to the another API request. So when you apply a login API and you receive token, then that token you can implement in a header, and that you can run through the whole collection runner. So your session is getting maintained. So you don't need to worry and do nothing for the cookies.
Okay. Can I remove this cookie? Yes.
I don't know about it. I'm not sure. Vasim, can you try?
No.
The backspace or something?
No, I think
yes. When you see the what was the menu over there to manage a cookie? It was coming into the paid version only, right, Vasim?
No, cookies. It is completely
in the workspace, in my workspace or invite or something. So no. In this free version, we cannot edit, write, delete. We can only view cookies.
We can remove cookies.
Okay. Can we try it here?
Yes. Sir, Vasim, sir.
Yes.
सेंड बटन है उसके नीचे कुकीज का वो है वो, उसको प्रेस करो ना. वी कैन रिमूव दिस कुकीज फ्रॉम हियर.
ओके
इफ यू कैन ऐड कुकीज.
Means you are removing cookies from the passing to the next API. You are not you are not removing from the API level, right? Like you have to decide either I have to pass this cookie value for the API or not. So for that purpose, we can use this.
And no, sir, if you delete it, or add anything specific, then your next API wouldn't accept it. Your API will fail.
No, sir. सपोज आप यहाँ से डिलीट करोगे ना कोई भी कुकीज तो पूरी आपकी जितने भी एपीआई में सब में वर्क वो सेम टू सेम ही होगा. कोई पर्टिकुलर एपीआई के लिए नहीं होगा.
ओके
क्योंकि ये चेक किया था क्योंकि ग्रोएप की एपीआई में हम कर रहे थे ना तभी मैंने ये फेस किया था.
सो एक्सप्लिसिटली वी कैन ऐड एंड डिलीट.
यस.
ओके
sure. I guess Hitesh has a very valid point, and it needs to be looked into as well. So definitely, I guess Vaseem and Harshi will look into that, and then we can come back on this. And basically, what is helpful for by doing that, and what is not?
Yes, sir.
Right. Ideal way is when you have a JWT and token-based API, then things should be managed from the token only. There is no need for the cookies. But when this is only like explicit case for the Grow app, where iOS was managing cookies by default and they were expecting cookies from the Android side. So in that case, we have to explicitly work on it. But ideally, the WooCommerce, the API which given by the WordPress team, they have to manage from the session token only. There is no specific requirement, but they had some technical glitch into their plugin. So that's why we need to work on add-on to support them. So that was the only case. In actual practical, there is no need, but to support their plugin, we have to do it in Android to add a manual cookies as suggested by Hitesh. We can also add more cookies into this postman as well.
Sounds good. Perfect. Okay. Vivesh, are you facing any issues?
Yes, sir. I just, no.
Oh, perfect. Sounds good. Okay. Any, Margie, any questions from your end?
No, sir. Not right now.
Sounds good. Perfect. So I guess this is a good information to move ahead. Hase sir, can you just like quickly showcase the that Excel sheet that you have created for API response and everything? So like we can share that, okay, what kind of how we are making a communication with the API team to provide the details.
Yes, we can do. Like Postman is also a beneficial tool to reduce a gap between API developer and mobile application developer. We cannot say nowadays only mobile application developer because APIs now we are using in web as well, right? So I'm going to share my screen.
Yep. Vaseem, you can stop sharing your screen.
Yes, sir, sure.
Okay, I just shared my screen. Is it visible?
Yep.
Okay, so what happens from the day one when I started analysis for this is the API document for the Grow app, but I usually do for the all the projects, right? So I start writing APIs on my end on a Google Shared Sheet only, and I keep edit access only to me and a lead of the API developer, the team lead or a project lead who is going to, and all the developers from the API and from iOS, Android or web, they will follow this. So we put the rules, we put the regulations, and we put how it will going to work, and they will be following. So let's say this is one get category. So this is the API method. This is type. The API will be the post. and this is the API status. So once API developer develop this, they do test in their local, then they deploy on a development environment. They again test it. They once give the confirmation to the TL, then only the TL mark it as a done here. And once it is done, we check the API in our code. But nowadays, what we do when this document is very strong enough. So what I write the request parameter here. Like this would be the key. This would be the ideal value. Like this is the request. And this would be the response. So from this response, iOS developer and Android developer can make their model. Now you see, this is get categories. This is the method name. Now always the method name is very much important. If I write the category, then what is it? There is no meaning for the method name. Is it a set category? Is it a get category? Is it a put category? Is it delete category? What we need to do? Get all the categories, save a category, delete a category. So this name isn't meaningful. So the name should be the meaningful. So that's why I call it as a get category. The method name is get category. So any like layman person read this, then they can understand the use of the API. Like this will return all the categories, right? So let's say this is ideal screen for me. This is shop by category. This is one of the screen in Grow app. So this returns all the categories like plants, flowers, farm and garden, and animal feed, right? So when I write a response here, they make their own MVC class in iOS and Android, and they integrate it. And they write one more dummy method, not an actual method, to call an API, get the response, set that response in MVC, and show that response in a list view, right? So they write a one more dummy method. They mimic like we have received response, and they are setting values. They are writing array and dictionary manually into MVC. Samajh mein aaya? One, request. Two, response. Three, set in MVC. Four, list view. So one and two, they don't do. But three and four, set values into MVC and show into list view. So they mimic one method. And they finish the whole UI implementation. The API integration. Like this way. API अभी तक बना नहीं है. Still वो लोग MVC में value put up करके UI functional. When you click on it, it will take you to the product listing screen. यहाँ पे click होकर product listing में जाएगा. तो वो सब कुछ काम खत्म कर देते हैं. जब API developer बताता है ना कि मेरा API हो गया, तो dummy method को वो लोग comment करते हैं और actual API का जो method है, उसको uncomment करते हैं और हमारा काम हो जाता है. So before they develop API, we can finish our work. समझ में आ रहा है? चार step है. एक request करना, दूसरा response आना, third response को parse करके MVC में डालना, fourth MVC से value get करके यहाँ पर listing में दिखाना. So हम लोग एक actual method रखते हैं जिसमें first and second step, third and fourth होता है, और एक dummy method रखते हैं जिसमें third and fourth होता है, MVC में value set करना और लाकर यहाँ पर दिखाना. आइडिया आया क्या कह रहा हूं मैं? सो जैसे ही वो लोग एपीआई कहते हैं कि हाँ हो गया है, हमें तो सिर्फ वो एक मेथड डमी मेथड को कमेंट करना है और एक्चुअल मेथड को अनकमेंट करके एक रन करना है सिर्फ, और श्योरिटी दे देनी है हाँ कंफर्म हो गया. सो वी आर, दिस इज द एपीआई डॉक्यूमेंट, राइट? दिस आर द नोट्स. So Postman is a beneficial tool, but Postman से ज़्यादा API document पे भी grip होना चाहिए. Like यही मैंने spelling दिया है, यही follow होना चाहिए. यही key and value दिया है, यही key and value follow होना चाहिए. मुझे plants data लाना है तो root में मुझे one pass करना है. मुझे pet का data लाना है तो root में मुझे two pass करना है. So that also has to be documented here. क्या values? जैसे वसीम ने बताया था ना variables in Postman. So if you have a good grip on a Postman or an API document, so without having the APIs, you can start working on your project. Tabhi API, any API like set profile, get profile, forgot password, change password, and you can finish your workout. So these are the APIs, and this is the summary. Like these are the rules and regulations for API developer and this mobile app developer. Like APIs has to be in a REST format. Request response has to be in a string format. Whenever I do in a string format only. There should be check for the version. There should be check for the platform. Maintain 200, 400 success and failure. Maintain 800.
Hello? Am I audible now?
Yes, yes.
Yes, yes, you are.
Okay. So then give example of all possible variations. When there would be 200, then what would be the response? When there would be 400, then what would be the response? Maintain namespace and camel code for each request and response. Maintain Excel file for message key, like all the validation messages for forgot password, change password, edit profile, login, registration. When they have a validation on their API level as well, then they should be having one Excel sheet. They have to maintain in an Excel sheet. So if QA is having any suggestion, like you put this message, this is not a correct, there is a typo mistake, there is a spelling mistake, then we can maintain from the Excel sheet. Listing APIs should have a pagination. All the listing APIs, let's say this four categories are visible here, but I have a 400 category. So it is not an ideal way to fetch all the 400 categories here. It has to be 10, 20, 30 in a slot of 10 or a slot of 5 or a slot of 50. So there should be the pagination. All the listing APIs should work on a pagination method. Pagination page size will be defined by backend team. So what I do, like, okay. Let me show you, this is product listing API, right? So here you don't see like start parameter 0 and a length 10. We generally do that way for the pagination. Yani ki 0 se start hoga aur 10 uska size hoga. Next would be 11 to 20. Next would be 21 to 30. But nahi. I pass only page number, page 1, page 2, page 3. Ab wo page mein kitna count aayega wo backend decide karega. So kabhi load balancing increase ho raha hai to product listing mein they can return 5 products, right? Agar performance acha chal raha hai, server acha hai, configuration acha hai, then they can return a 10 products. So yahan pe ek limit nahi ho jayega. What happens, pagination change karne ke liye hum log iOS Android mein kaam karna padega aur pura application fir se upload karna padega naya version. To wo na karne ki wajah se hum log sirf page number pass karenge. Abhi wo page mein kitna product aayega wo backend decide karega. We can have 50, we can have 5, we can have 10, 20 as per the performance and load. We can have it here. Understood? Okay. This is ideal response for the 400. Agar kuch bhi fail ho raha hai, koi bhi validation dikhana hai, to isi tarah se aayega. The code and the message key. The 800 forced to download. Right? That we are managing from the version. So let's say TikTok close kar diya. But TikTok ke jo users hai, unke APIs, unke phone mein to jo rahega, agar platform unka run hai, unko koi aur app pe redirect kar dena hai. Then from the backend, we can change the URL and we can switch actually the apps. Now, this is not your current actually working app. This is a new app you have to use. Same, wahan pe bhi version se bhi manage kar sakte hai. This is 1200 case. Agar session break hua hai, जैसे JWT टोकन मैंने बताया वो एक्सपायर हो गया, मोबाइल से लॉगिन किया था, नाउ अभी वेब से लॉगिन किया, आईओएस से किया था, अभी एंड्रॉइड से. सो फर्स्ट यूजर को अगर लॉग आउट करना है, देन वी कैन मैनेज फ्रॉम द 1200. यू हैव लॉग्ड इन डिफरेंट ऐप और वेब. सो दीज आर ऑल द केसेस, द रूल्स एंड रेगुलेशन वी हैव टू गिव टू देम फॉर द एपीआई डेवलपर एंड द मोबाइल डेवलपर. सो दिस वे वी कैन टेक अ बेनिफिट. This document access is only with Nilay and me. So we only write here, like this would be the form. So if any issue comes from the API developer or a mobile application developer, then we go to this document and we find out like who is wrong. The API developer is wrong or the mobile application developer is wrong. Otherwise, वो fighting चलता ही रहता है. मैंने तो ये भेजा था, उसने चेंज कर दिया. चेंज करेगा तो भी यहाँ पे डॉक्यूमेंट में हमें बता के अपडेट करना है. अगर यहाँ पर नहीं है, उसने चेंज कर दिया बैकएंड में, तो भी API developer पकड़ा जाएगा. भाई क्यों चेंज किया, की का क्यों चेंज किया, टाइप क्यों चेंज किया. So the API document is very much required and it has to be maintained. So let's say I am out of station and I don't have iOS application, Android application and website with me. And all of a sudden I got an email about some issue in mobile application from client. Then I can check this API document and I can figure out. I straight away call to that developer and I can suggest like this could be the reason and you can resolve it here. So that is a benefit. Otherwise, what happens? I have to call iOS developer, apna Xcode open kar, simulator mein run kar application, ye request le, API developer ko de, wahan pe tu response cross verify kar, check kar aur mujhe resolution de. Kitna problem? Sabko weekends pe disturb karna, overnight disturb karna, pura. So if you have a postman, Wasim has given a very good presentation. If you have a postman, all the APIs, let me show you my postman. This is my postman. I have all the projects collections here. I can check any API of any project. This is for me. And I can figure out like what is the reason. So mujhe kya action karna hai, that will help me as a lead, as a project lead. If I have a postman and document API document, then that will help a lot. Also, it will reduce a communication gap. Generally, hota hai na, API developer ko bata de, wo kar le, ye. Usko bol de. Abhi API developer bola, mujhe kab bola tha, pata nahi hai. Orally bola tha, main bhool gaya, yaad nahi hai, mujhe written mein de do. Ye sab kuch gap reduce karega. Postman and API document. Yes. Okay. Now, let me show you something. If you don't want to maintain an API document separately, then there is an option. Export, and as you have seen in Wasim, there was a published document. So published document will also help you. Wasim, I'm going to stop my screen share. Can you share a screen and show me that three dots? The three dots, the published document, something. Go down. Yes, public docs. See, this will open a particular URL, right? And all the writings are there. You can get a PDF as well. Like this is the URL, this is the headers. Collection discovery or a URL something, go down. But that would be only possible if we have a, like that paid version, maybe. Publish collection. Tap on this public collection. Publish collection. Publish collection. This. Yes, yes, yes. Go down.
Click on this URL there above. There is URL.
Yes. This URL, documenter dot. Yes. See, you give this URL to any of your developer, you will get all the data. See, the body type is there, the headers are there, the methods are there, the get type, put type, post type, everything is there. Content type, authentication, everything is here. You can also have the curl code. So if you have a, you should have a good grip on a postman and the API document. This will overall reduce frustration, overhead hours, the document, the maintenance of your project. Everything will get reduced. The leads should follow.
Okay, sounds good. This seems like good information for the APIs and everything. Thank you so much, Hasia and Vaseem, for providing this details. Team, any questions? We're just about to conclude the thing.
I'm Haswi. Say.
Haswi.
Hello. Your father gave us a good presentation today.
Hello, Garaj. Hello, Garo. Hi, Kedo. Hi. Good morning, Kedo.
Okay.
All of a sudden, call per I ne ke che. I am Haswi.
Perfect, sir. Hope you're having a great time with your daughter this Sunday afternoon. Yes, guys, happy weekend. Bye bye. Thank you.
Happy weekend. Bye bye, everyone. See you.